पेन, सी बाय आर बाय यूजिंग ब्लॉक डायग्राम रिडक्शन टेक्निक्स, बाय यूजिंग ब्लॉक डायग्राम रिडक्शन टेक्निक। So in this particular thing, the question is given by, you can take the question along with me. Okay, so we can take this with minus and this with plus and this with minus, and this is plus, and here it is minus, and here it is going back. Okay, so this is the numerical what they have given. Okay, so here h1, h2, and here you can take h3. Okay, please take this one, h3. So this is the question what they have given. So when you see this particular question, what is the first step I told you? So you can always go by saying the any blocks which are in series with each other, any blocks which are parallel to each other. Okay, so is there anything like this in your numerical? Any block which are in series and any block which are in parallel to each other?
No, sir.
No. So any minor feedback loop is there? Any minor feedback loop is there?
No.
No. So there is neither feedback loop nor anything is there. So now what to do now?
Shifting the h1 takeoff point after g4 block, sir.
Shifting the takeoff point after g4. Good.
G4.
Shifting h1 block after g4. So write down solution. Solution. So here, right, you can write that this particular point we can shift shifting takeoff point. Okay. After Jaipur. Okay. So now when we want to shift the takeoff point after Jaipur, what exactly will happen is we'll get the same things will be there. Okay. So G1 will be there here. Summing points, the initial is R. And it is G2. And here it is another summing point, and here it is G3, and we are going to consider G4 also. So what we are telling is we are going to shift. So this particular point is there. So here it is H1 is there. So we are shifting the takeoff point after G4. So we must add a block by 1/G4. Correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So once we do this particular process, so next remaining things I am going to write it here. So here it is H2, which is coming here, and here it is H3. So from the same point, these things are coming. Okay. So this will be the directions minus, minus, minus. Here it is plus. So anywhere you take it, this particular indication should be made very properly. Why? Because the indications are very, very important. So if you don't indicate properly, the meaning itself is going to be the wrong thing. Okay. So now when you see this particular diagram, so now we can say this, these two are in a series, and these two are in series, correct? Please make a note of it, all of you. And once you write this one, write the next block diagram. So once you take this particular numerical, so what is the next step I can say is, so we'll reduce like this. So when you're reducing, we'll take R here, and we can take the summing point, and we can take the G1 here, and it will go like this. Another summing point will come, and there it is G2 will also come into picture. So later, here the summing point will be there, okay, as usual. So here G3 and G4 will become in series. So the multiplication factor is G3, G4, so which is C, it is given as output C here. And this particular block, okay, so here it will become what? H1 divided by G1, sorry, H1 divided by G4. So that will be connected as this particular part. Okay, and then here you can see that so this takeoff point is there. No, see, the same point is being taken as a common point. So I am going to split that particular common points. So like this. So here is one point, and the later this first point I can take as H3, and I can give to here. Okay. So here it will be like this. So when you see this particular diagram, now what you can conclude? So this particular process you understood, right? The same takeoff point is there, no? This particular takeoff point. So this one I'm splitting. This is the first one I can say. This is the second one I can say. This is the third one I can say. All are originating from the same point. So I am just taking this particular line, and I am going to consider this is first point, this is second point, this is third point. Clear? So separately I will take, so that I can conclude that, okay, so that I can conclude here that this particular part is there now. This particular part will act as a minor feedback loop, correct?
Minor feedback loop.
Yes, minor feedback loop. So write it down, all of you. So once you take this as minor feedback loop, we can reduce the minor feedback loop, okay? So we can reduce the minor feedback loop. So if we reduce the minor feedback loop, so it will look like, okay, so here it will be R, and here it is summing point will come, and here it is G1, and here it is the point, okay, and summing point, and here it is G2. So now in this particular part, okay, so I can say that, okay, G of S divided by negative feedback is there, so it will become 1 plus G of S into H of S is the formula based answer. So now G of S value will become what? G3 G4 divided by 1 plus G3 G4 into H2. So here G of S will become what? G3 G4, and here H of S will become what? H2. So replace the values as per the diagram. So you will get this particular blocks, correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So now G3, G4, you will reduce. So it will become what? 1 plus G3, G4, H2. So here it will become what? C. So now obviously this particular thing will be there. So H1 divided by G4 is not reduced. So it will take here. And the last thing is what? H3. It is also not reduced. So this I will take it here. This is minus. Okay. So now this block diagram, when you see it, what is the thing you can understand? So you can understand that this G2 and this particular block is in series. Okay, we can reduce it. Okay, in the next step, right, these two blocks are in series. What we can do is, if you shift this one, okay. So if you club this one, G2, it will become what? G2, G3, G4. G2, G3, G4. And once you made this one, this particular block will be in, this will act as a minor feedback loop. Clear? Correct or not? See, here it is in the forward direction, but here H1 divided by G4 in the reverse direction. So it will become a minor feedback loop, correct?
Sir.
So now please reduce the minor feedback loop and tell me the answer. So if you want to reduce the answer, okay. So here we can write that. So this particular block will be equal to, or else I can say that this particular feedback loop coefficient I consider g dash. Okay. So or else anything you can consider. So just for a presentation, it will is what g2, g3, g4 divided by 1 plus g2, g3. G4 into H1 divided by G4. So G4, G4 get cancels. Sorry. So here I have done a mistake. I have taken only the numerator. I will right once again. Okay, so the full thing is what g2 g3 g4 divided by 1 plus g3 g4 h2 whole divided by, okay, this particular value will be the g of s. So here 1 plus this particular value, that is g2 g3 g4 divided by 1 plus g3 g4 h2 into h1 by g4. Clear? So this particular thing will come into picture here. G4 g4 get cancels, so you will be left out with and they can take this particular 1 plus g3 g4 h2 LCM. So there you'll get g2 g3 g4 divided by, so if you shift this LCM part to another side, the whole thing if you take, so here 1 plus g3 g4 h2 plus g2 g3 h1. So this is the value you are going to get. Have you all got this answer?
Yes, sir.
Very good. So once you get this particular answer now, so here what I can say is, so we can reduce the block diagram as follows, like you will get R and you will get this one, and here you will get G1. And here it will become what g dash. So g dash, instead of whole thing I am taking only the g dash for simplicity. So and here from the last side there is a h3 which is coming. So here it is minus and here it is plus. You are going to get, when you see this, these two are in series, so you will get like and there it is. So now this particular whole configuration is going to be minor feedback loop. So this everybody got. I'll give you 1 minute of time. Those who are not arrived, come on. Please arrive. By that time I will meet Vinita. Okay. So now Any 10 of you can confirm that whether you arrived at this particular answer?
Yes, sir.
One, Vasudha has answered. What about remaining?
Yes, sir.
Okay, next. Two is over. I want 10 replies at least out of 37. Panindra, okay. Third, three replies. What about next one? See, as you show the interest, it will be good. So what about another people? Please make it fast and kindly reply that whether you arrived at this particular point or not. So shall I move forward? Okay. So now this particular answer will be getting reduced to what? G1, okay, here it will be G1. So G1 G dash divided by 1 plus G1 G dash into H3. So replace the value of G dash, it will be what? G1. So G dash value is what? G2, G3, G4 divided by 1 plus G3, G4, H2. It will be plus G3, G2, H1. So whole divided by the value. Here once again it will be what? 1 plus G1, H3 I will take here, G dash value is what? G2, G3, G4 divided by 1 plus G3, G4, H2 plus G3, G2, H1. Correct? So now, when you got this particular answer, you make it simplified version and tell me the answer. So if you simplify it, I'll give you 2 minutes of time. You just verify the answer. C by R is equal to. You will get G1, G2, G3, G4 divided by 1 plus G3, G4, H2 plus G2, G3, H1 plus G1, G2, G3, and H3. So kindly verify, this is the answer you are going to get. Take 2 minutes of time, solve it, and confirm with the answer.
Sir, in the answer,
tell me.
In denominator, G1, G2, G3, G4, H3, right, sir?
Will it be G4, H3?
Yes,
G1, G2, G3, G4, H3. Correct. So it will be G4, okay? So G4 will also come. So because you take this one, it will be G1, G2, G3, G4, H3. Correct. Okay. You got this answer?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Only 2, 3. What about remaining people? So remaining people, please solve it at the earliest and confirm that you are getting the same answer. Nobody will confirm. Okay, we'll move on to the next numerical. So, second numerical for today, same thing, find C of S divided by R of S by using block diagram reduction techniques. So the block diagram is given by one particular block. Okay. So it is connected to the G1. Next thing is what it is connected to the G2. And there it is connected to some endpoint C of S. It is R of S. So here after this one, from between the G1 and G2, there is a G3. So which is going in the same direction but with a negative sign. So negative sign does not always meaning that it is a feedback. It can be forward path also. Is minus, and from here it is connected. There it is called as what, G4, and there it is given in the minus sign. Okay, so now this is not so easy. And not so difficult also. Only one step, if you crack it neatly, so it will be correct. Okay. So now tell me, so what you can do for this particular block diagram? Is there any block which are in series and parallel?
G2 parallel, sir.
G2, G3 parallel, very good. So if you reduce the G2, G3 parallel blocks, G1 will be series with G2 minus G3. So that will become the, G1 will be series with G2 minus G3. So that particular block also I can able to reduce. Okay. So now we can consider this one parallel block. Write down solution, parallel blocks. So it will give rise to G1, and this particular block the value will be G2 minus G3. Why? Because minus sign is there, plus sign is there, both are going in the same direction. We need to add in the terms of the values. So this particular value will become G2 minus G3. If it is a positive sign, then it would have been G2 minus G2 plus G3. So now in this particular numerical, once again I can say that these two blocks are in series. Correct? If you reduce this particular block, I can say that so you can write it one on another diagram. So you can club this one, you can say that so it will be like G1 into G2 minus G3, so that is equal to G1 G2 minus G1 G3. So after that one, what you can do? So there is no block which are in series, there are no block which are in parallel, and there are no feedback loop also, and takeoff point are not there to take it to the right side. So we left out with the last option, that is take the summing points to the left side. Okay, so now this is the summing point which is there. Okay, so here this particular summing point is there, no? So shift this summing point, shift the summing point to left. Okay, when you are shifting this particular summing point to the left, so we'll see what exactly we are going to get. So here same thing will be there, that is R. Here also R of S we are going to consider. So there will be a summing point here, and here the block value will be G1 G2 minus G1 G3. So it will be C of S. And later stage, when you're shifting the summing point, what exactly happened? So here, from here, if you start, so you'll get H1 here, which is not a problem. So once you get H1, okay, so we'll get H2 also. Why? Because So you will get H2. So since it is in a positive sign, no need of worrying. So we will shift the summing point after H2. That means what? In this particular direction to the left side. So here H2 is also will come into picture here. So its value will consider as plus only, and will connecting to here will consider minus, because minus is present. So now here what exactly happens when you're shifting a summing point, so the G4 is associated with it, so the same block value we need to add. So here what exactly will come is, so G4 is present, so as a rule, so we must add a block H2 also. Since the block is the negative and the direction is also negative, see here G4 is going with negative, so the same thing is written negative. Okay, so this is the shifting procedure. I just wanted to tell you once again that we are shifting this particular summing point to the left. So when you shift this particular summing point to the left, no problem, we'll shift it. So we'll take the same block H1, H2, so here also H1, H2 will be there. So G4 is there. So along with G4, there is a multiplication factor which crosses the block. Okay, this summing point is crossing the H2, so the same H2 value we have taken. Same direction, same flow, everything is maintained the same fashion. Clear? So now we can see that these two blocks are in series, and these two blocks are in series. Okay. And after you considering these two blocks are in series with each other, so we can merge. So we can merge the summing point, this one and this one, summing point 1 and summing point 2, we can merge. So this is plus, sign is there, plus into minus will become minus. So minus into minus will become plus. Okay. So it will be reduced to single point so it is G1 G2 minus G1 G3 that is equal to C of S. So here R of S. So here two blocks which are in series, that is H1, H2. So these two things are going minus. So here also once again the same blocks like G4, H2. So this is, that is being combined also. So here also we will go with this particular block. So once we get this particular thing, so now we can see that these two blocks are in parallel and this is in the minor feedback loop. Okay, so parallel block as well as minor feedback loop, it is going to become. So here the sign is plus, not the minus. Okay, minus into minus, plus it will come. And there it is minus. Is it clear to you, all of you? So we can split this particular summing point, or else you can directly write the answer also. So you can see that here it is the minor feedback loop. And these are parallel block. Parallel block. I can say that if this is, sorry. So if you just take this series or your parallel blocks into consideration, so you will get R of S into here the block value is 1 here because same thing is going. So 1 plus G4H2. Okay, so this particular entire block value if you take, so it will come like G1, G2 minus G1, G3 the whole divided by 1 plus G1, G2 minus G1, G3 into H1, H2. Okay. So finally these two are in series with each other. So multiply this one. So you will get C of S divided by R of S is equal to 1 plus G4H2 into this particular G1, G2 minus G1, G3 divided by 1 plus G1, G2 minus G1, G3 into H1, H2. Okay. So all of you got this answer. Anybody is having any doubt? All of you got the same answer. Did you solve all of you?